Now, let me explain about the loss of friction. So, on what factors the friction depends upon? Okay, these are very interesting and very easy. Let us see them one by one. See, in the first class, we have discussed the cause of friction. What is the cause of friction? It is nothing but the interlocking. Interlocking is the main cause of friction. So, interlocking depends upon the surfaces. If you take tar road, if you take ordinary cement road, or if you take the tiled floor, so the surfaces are different. Where do you think the friction is more? Yes, obviously on the tar road. Same objects may be kept on tar road, cement road, and tiled floor. So in the three cases, the object experiences more friction on the tar road than on the tiled floor. So the first one is friction depends upon the nature of the surface. And let's look at into the second point, that is, the friction always acts tangential to the surface and in the direction opposite to the motion of the object. See, for example, the block is moving in this direction as the external force is acting in this direction. So the friction always acts in the opposite direction and tangential to the surface. In this direction, friction acts. That's all. This is the second beautiful point. And third one is friction never depends upon the area of contact. So for this we have a small proof. I will explain it. If I take this body, if I take this block, say its mass is M, gravitational force mg acts in the downward direction. So in this case, if the friction is some 5 newtons, same surface, same object, and the object has 6 sides, this block has same kind of surface. For example, say this box, it has same kind of surface in all directions. If I place this object on a table, this is the area of contact in this case one. In this case, if I apply some force F in this direction like this, say the friction is 5 newtons, the same block means the mass remains the same. If I place the block like this, so the area of contact is decreased now. If I apply force in this direction, then also the friction is observed that it is 5 newtons. So when the object is same, means nature of surface and mass is same, the friction is independent upon the area of contact. Even if this area is contact or this area is in contact, in both the cases the friction is same. So three points we have studied, and let us study the fourth one. It is very, very important. So ఒక చిన్న ఎక్స్‌పెరిమెంట్ చూస్తున్నాం ఇప్పుడు. ఈ యొక్క బ్లాక్ నేను ఇలా ఉంచాను. ఈ కేస్ లో ఈ ఏరియా అంతా కూడా కాంటాక్ట్ లో ఉంది. దీనిపై నేను ఇప్పుడు ఫోర్స్ ని అప్లై చేశాను అనుకోండి. మూవ్ అవుతుంది కదా. సే ద ఫ్రిక్షన్ ఇస్ 5 న్యూటన్స్. ఇఫ్ ఐ కీప్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ లైక్ దిస్ with same area of cross section like this. Now if I apply the force on this body, then also the friction is found to be 5 newtons because the surface is same and the mass is same in both the cases. Let us see another experiment. Now I have kept this object like this and I have applied some force on this like this. It has some friction. Now I have kept one more block on this. Now if I apply force on this, its friction is not 5 newtons as before. Though the area of contact is same, surface is same, its friction is changed. It's more than 5 newtons now. See, if I place one more block on this, surface, nature of surface is same, area of contact is same, but will it be 6 newtons or 7 newtons as before? No. As the weight is increased, now I need to apply more force to just move it. Means the friction is increased, right? So the friction depends upon the mass of the body. Why the mass of the body? Let us see. Okay. అంటే ఒక బ్లాక్ ఉంచినప్పుడు దానిపైన ఇంకో బ్లాక్ ఉంచినప్పుడు దానిపైన ఇంకో బ్లాక్ ఉంచినప్పుడు మూడు కేసెస్ లో కూడాను ఫ్రిక్షన్ అనేది ఒకటే కాదు మారింది ఎందుకనేది చూద్దాం. సో ఒకే బ్లాక్ ఉండేటప్పుడు ఫ్రిక్షన్ 5 న్యూటన్స్ అయితే टू ब्लाक्स उड़ेटपुर थ्री ब्लाक्स उड़ेटपुर फ्रिक्शन मोर देन फाइव आई दी इंकोक एग्जापल चूदा यह ब्लाक इपू पुष्ते फ्रिक्शन अने फाइव न्यूटन्स दी पैन गट प्रेस इप्ड चूँ मूव फाइव न्यूटन्स फोर्स तो नो आई हैव टू अप्लाई मोर फोर्स ई हैव टू अप्लाई मोर फोर्स सो एम जरिगिंदि अनेदि इप्पुडु मनं स्टडी चेद्दां सो ओक ब्लाक उंडेटप्पुडु असलु एला उंटुंदो चूद्दां वेन द ब्लाक इज कैप्ट ऑन द सर्फेस वाट आर द फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन इट वन इज इट्स ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स एमजी एक्ट्स इन द डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन एंड नॉर्मल रिएक्शन एक्ट्स इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन वेर एन इज इक्वल टू एम इंटू जी इप्पुडु नेनु एं चेसानु दीनिपैन इंको ब्लाक नि प्लेस चेसानु प्लेस చేసిన వెంటనే దీని యొక్క మాస్ సంథింగ్ ఎం డాష్ అనుకుంటే ఇప్పుడు ఇక్కడ ఈ సర్ఫేస్ మీద కిందకి పని చేసినటువంటి ఫోర్స్ ఎంత అయిందండి ఎం ప్లస్ ఎం డాష్ ఇంటూ జీ ఆబ్వియస్లీ ద నార్మల్ రియాక్షన్ ఆల్సో ఇంక్రీజెస్ ద న్యూ నార్మల్ రియాక్షన్ ఆఫ్టర్ ప్లేసింగ్ ద బ్లాక్ సే ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎం డాష్ వేర్ ఎం డాష్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎం ప్లస్ ఎం డాష్ ఇంటూ జీ సో ఇక్కడ ఏం జరిగింది నార్మల్ రియాక్షన్ ఇంక్రీజ్ అయింది ఫ్రిక్షన్ కూడా ఇంక్రీజ్ అయింది ఇప్పుడు ఇంకొక బ్లాక్ ని ఇక్కడ ప్లేస్ చేద్దాం అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది వెయిట్ పెరుగుతుంది కదా సే ఎం ప్లస్ ఎం డాష్ ప్లస్ ఎం డబుల్ డాష్ సే ఇట్స్ మాస్ ఇస్ ఎం డబుల్ డాష్ మరి వెయిట్ పెరిగింది కాబట్టి ఆబ్వియస్గా నార్మల్ రియాక్షన్ కూడా పెరుగుతుంది సే నౌ ద నార్మల్ రియాక్షన్ ఇస్ ఎం డబుల్ డాష్ వెర్ ఎం డబుల్ డాష్ ఈక్వల్ హౌ మచ్ తుచి అంటే నార్మల్ రియాక్షన్ ఇంక్రీజ్ అయింది మరి ఆబ్వియస్గా ఫ్రిక్షన్ కూడా ఇంక్రీజ్ అయింది సో వీ కెన్ కంక్లూడ్ దట్ ద ఫ్రిక్షన్ ఇస్ డైరెక్ట్లీ ప్రొపోర్షనల్ టు ద నార్మల్ రియాక్షన్ సో యాజ్ లాంగ్ యాజ్ ద నార్మల్ రియాక్షన్ ఇంక్రీజెస్ ద ఫ్రిక్షన్ ఇంక్రీజెస్ ఇజంట్ ఇట్ సో యాజ్ టు రిమూవ్ దిస్ ప్రొపోర్షనాలిటీ వీ నీడ్ టు కీప్ ఎ కాన్స్టెంట్ దట్ ఈస్ ఎఫ్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు సమ్ మ్యూ ఇంటూ ఎన్ యాజ్ యూఆర్ స్పీకింగ్ అబౌట్ ద స్టాటిక్ ఫ్రిక్షన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎఫ్ఎస్ fs is equal to some us into n where mus is called as quotient of static friction now let's see what is quotient of static friction mus mus is equal to I can take this n towards left it becomes fs by n it is the ratio between static friction to the normal reaction is called as quotient of static friction as the units of friction is newtons normal reaction units also newtons so both get cancelled and mu has a unitless quantity as it is ratio it doesn't have any units got it now if I ask you one question what is your answer if the normal reaction is doubled what about the quotient of friction will it be doubled no it is taken as proportionality constant that's why even if the normal reaction is doubled halved or tripled 100 times whatever the quotient of friction doesn't change it states about the nature of the two surfaces it is actually the property of the nature of the two contact surfaces it doesn't depend upon any other factor it will not be changed it is constant for particular two surfaces is it clear so let us conclude about the laws of static friction once that is one is it depends upon the nature of the surfaces it is always opposite to the direction of motion and always tangential to the contact surface it doesn't depend upon the area of contact fourth one is the static friction is directly proportional to the normal reaction so keep it in mind write down all of them and we have discussed about the laws of kinetic friction kinetic friction also same kind the kinetic friction is represented by fk fk is directly proportional to the normal reaction again so as to remove this proportionality we need to keep a constant fk is equal to mu k into n similarly mu k also a ratio of quotient kinetic friction to the normal reaction mu k is equal to fk by n it is also ratio it also doesn't have any units when compared to the mu s and mu k is lesser than mu s as you know that kinetic friction is lesser than static friction mu k also less than mu s let us do a small experiment to compare the sliding friction and rolling friction I would like to slide this box once and let us see how I am applying the force not moving yes moving but I'm applying some force Now I would like to place this box on some cylinders. I have kept this on some four cylinders and see how much forces. Very easy, very easy. See, it is easily moving, right? Even if I remove the force, still it is moving. Even if I remove the force, still it is moving. But when the cylinders are not there, the moment when I remove the force, it is stopping. Means the rolling friction is less than sliding or kinetic friction. Okay. So on what factors does it depend upon? Rolling friction also depends upon the normal reaction only. As long as the normal reaction is more, the rolling friction is more. See, it is not easy to push a heavier car than a lighter car. As the mass is more for it, it is tough to move it. So to remove this proportionality, we need to keep a constant for is equal to mu r into n, where this mu r is called as quotient of rolling friction. Mu r is equal to f r by n. This is also ratio. As this is ratio, mu r doesn't have any units. Okay, when compared to this quotient of kinetic friction, static friction, mu r is the least possible friction. That's why mu r is less than mu k, that is less than mu s. In other words, if I write mu s first, mu s, mu k, mu r, what is the symbol? Mu s is greater than mu k is greater than mu r. Similarly, if I take the relation between fs, fk and fr, what symbol do you keep? Fs is greater than fk, that is greater than fr. If I write fr, fk and fs, what symbol do you keep now? Fr is less than fk is less than fs. Okay, so this is about loss of friction. In the next lecture, let us discuss about the motion of an object on a rough horizontal surface.